Make sure you're not nerfing the crazy new gaming PC you just built with a slow SSD. Not all drives are created equal, so make sure you're not ruining your $3,000 PC with a slow drive. How fast your storage can read and write data will affect anything you do with your PC, so this is definitely not a place where you would want to cheap out on. This is going to affect everyday tasks like how long it takes to turn on your PC, to even launching games and copying files over if you're a content creator. This video is sponsored by Samsung, who sent over their 990 Pro SSD, which I'm super excited to use for this video. I'm going to show you a couple instances with my old SSD and compare it to the Samsung 990 Pro so we can see the difference. My old SSD isn't very fast, but I didn't notice how slow it was until I started recording the benchmarks for this video. This is why paying attention to what kind of storage you're putting into your computer is so important. I better not catch you using a hard drive as your boot drive. Nowadays, I almost always use an M.2 SSD because it doesn't need any cables, but even between M.2 SSDs, they're not all the same. There are a couple different PCIe versions in market, and the most common you'll see are PCIe 3.0 and 4.0. PCIe 4.0 drives pretty much double the overall data transfer rate, making everything so much faster. With my current SSD, it takes almost 40 seconds to turn my PC on, which is unacceptable. Storage speed affects so much more than just turning on your computer, so I wanted to run this SSD through a storage benchmark. This benchmark is going to give the SSD a score based on how well it does on a variety of different real-world gaming scenarios. Some of the different scenarios are loading different games, recording 1080p gameplay video, also saving game progress, installing games, or copying folders over. My old SSD scored a 2048, which would have been a good SAT score back in the day, but was actually below average for this. Now it's time to upgrade that slow drive into a fast one. I was actually going to upgrade to the Samsung 980 Pro, but the Samsung 990 Pro is actually even better, with random read and write speeds that are up to 40% and 55% faster than the 980 Pro. The Samsung 990 Pro also has up to 50% improved performance per watt over the 980 Pro, meaning it can be way more efficient while using less power. Upgrading your SSD is one of the easiest upgrades you can do on your PC, so never fear if you haven't done this before. We're gonna start off by removing the SSD heatsink. There's gonna be several slots on your motherboard, so I'm just putting this into the bottom one so I can transfer my files over with the old SSD still installed. My motherboard just has a clip to hold the SSD in place, so I don't need to screw it, and then now all you have to do is peel off the plastic protecting the thermal pad and re-screw that heatsink back on. If you're just adding storage to your PC, you can skip this step, but I want to make this new SSD my boot drive so that I can see faster load times when starting up my computer. Samsung has this data migration tool that makes everything super easy, so all I had to do was select which drive my boot drive was, and then it just automatically transferred over. With that one change, I was able to reduce the time it took to turn on my PC by 25%. Before, it took almost 40 seconds, and this time it took only 28. Now, before you go and throw away your old drive, you can still use it to store photos, videos, and other documents while keeping the things you want to load fast, like your OS and other games, on your new drive. I also ran the new SSD through the same storage benchmark we put the old one through, where it compared different game save, load, and download times, and this one did 65% better, even beating the average score. Again, huge shout out to Samsung for sponsoring this video. If you want to get your own Samsung 990 Pro, check out the link in the description below.